I get a little teary-eyed in the mornings when I look out and see this big old storage pod and think about all of the down-to-earth woodworking equipment being locked inside this 16-foot box. But pretty soon, I'll be able to move it inside. First, we have to get the garage converted into my new dream shop. So let's go inside and get started. Wow, what a mess. Hard to believe all my tools are actually out in a storage pod, as crowded as this is. But it'll all get in here, and it'll all be neat and clean when I'm done. Looking forward to that. I did leave a little corner cleared out over here, because that's where I'm going to start. First thing I'm going to do is run the electrical that needs to run through that corner. Put in some insulation, sheath a couple of the walls on the inside, and build my stairs up to the second level. Then I can start to clear out some of this and continue around the walls around the shop. Got to take it a step at a time, so let's get started on the electrical work. Just finishing up my story pole. You know, we use story sticks all the time in building furniture. In the shop, I'm going to use a story pole. Let me show you how that's going to help. I cut my story pole so that it has a nice tight fit between the top and bottom plates of the walls. Hopefully that's consistent around the room. Along the top up here, I've marked a chase or mark two places, one for a 110-volt circuit and the other for a 220-volt circuit. That's so I'll remember where the wires are, and so down the road, I won't ever run a nail into that area. Also, for neatness reasons, this will keep my lines even around all the walls. I've also marked an area here for no wires. What that's for is this is at the height where I typically mount French cleats. As you know, if you've seen any of my other videos in my previous shop, I use French cleats extensively to hang cabinets and shop jigs from the wall. I put an up arrow on here. I don't think I'll forget which way is up, but never hurts to be careful. I've marked right here the area and the lines where I'll mount all of the switch boxes. This is a little higher than a household switch box, but for a reason. The center line of the switch is at 52 inches, which puts the bottom of the switch above 48. If I lean a sheet of plywood up against the wall, I won't break a switch. Always good to plan ahead. I've marked an area for three more lines down here to run additional electrical lines. And towards the bottom down here at 18 inches above the floor, I've marked the space where I'll mount all the outlet boxes for the electrical outlets. There may be some variations for a couple of the 220 outlets, but we'll deal with that later. This will give me consistency around the shop. It'll make it pretty, not that that really matters, but it'll also serve down the road as a memory tool, so when I get ready to drive that big nail in the wall, I can just hold this up and say, uh-oh, I'm about to hit a wire if I drive a nail there. If you've got a lot of holes to drill, don't mess around. Use a plug-in drill. It'll speed things up. See what I mean? Before I could start pulling wires, one of the things was to put a board up here. I'll put another one down here, above and below the breaker box, so I have something to attach the wires to, just another little code thing. In this corner, I've got 2x4s here to nail my siding to, but I don't have a 2x4 on this side of the corner. Now, I could just toenail one in and be done with it, but that would create me a little bit of difficulty in running the wires. So what I did was I cut a board just for a loose fit in here, snug, but not impossible. And I put two nailing blocks. I pre-drilled holes in those because they're real short little pieces of 2x4 and I didn't want to split them. So I pre-drilled holes and screwed those into place. And this, I can then just move over and nail it into those nailing blocks when I'm ready to go. Perfect fit. However, I don't want to install it yet, because then I would be running wires and trying to snake them through this corner. Also, when I get ready to insulate, I'd have a difficult time stuffing insulation in there. And I do want this building to be tight. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my story pole, mark off the locations, pre-drill the holes in this 2x4, and then just lay it in here loose. I'll run the wires. After I get done doing that, I'll put insulation in here, and then I'll snug this board up and nail her home. And my corner will be done with a lot less effort. Running the wires goes pretty fast if you have a plan and you've worked it out ahead of time. It's taking me a little longer. With the price of wire these days, it's tempting to try to be frugal and save a few inches every chance you get, but don't. As it turns out, electricians kind of have the same old joke as carpenters. You know, we always say, measure twice, cut once, and then somebody says, oh yeah, I forgot to bring my board stretcher. I hear electricians all the time say, hey, I forgot to bring my wire stretcher, leave me plenty of slack. So, that's what I'm doing. I've run wires before and wound up with not enough in the box to make the connection, and it's kind of frustrating. I knew this one was going to be the tough one. This is for one of my 220 volt lines, so it's got four 12 gauge connectors in it. It's stiff, it's ugly, and hard to pull, but it'll be worth it. Just doing a little cleaning up here, getting the wood chips out of the wall cavities before I start insulating. Got the rough wiring stubbed out into the boxes. I'm going to button up this corner over here with that loose 2x4. That was real handy. And these two walls are rough wired now, at least this wall halfway down. This corner is done, so I'm ready to insulate. Put the siding up and start building my stairs up to the upper level. Got to take it a little section at a time so I can keep making some room here in the shop. Thanks for watching. This has been sort of step one in remodeling the garage and turning it into my dream workshop. I hope you'll stay tuned for the next section, and thanks for watching.